won't buy any more products from Fat Shark after this post.
Confidence won't unclog your arteries.
Gymshark just doing this for the social media, lamal.
Thanks for demotivating me.
I'm all for body
positivity. That's not beautiful. That's unhealthy.
If you took 2 seconds to click on this girl's profile,
Nelly London, eating disorder recovery.
This post, like, didn't at you in any single way.
I saw this post and I was like, wow, cool.
If you're overweight, you're unhealthy, and that's indicative of the way you eat.
Because they think everybody at the gym is an asshole like this.
What am I trying to say? I forget.
So a couple of days ago, Gymshark posted this photo of this girl, and the caption read,
"Because we are all both soft whilst also being incredibly strong. One side is not weaker, less valid, or less worthy. Both exist together perfectly. Beautiful words, beautiful body, beautiful soul, at Nelly London."
Maybe I'm just naive and have higher hopes for humanity than it deserves, but I saw this post and I was like, wow, cool. There's a company posting a person wearing athletic clothes that probably looks like most of the people buying athletic clothes.
Insanity!
But apparently that's not what the people who follow Gymshark thought.
Won't buy any more products from Fat Shark after this post. Unfollowed. Thanks for demotivating me, cryface emoji. How is this a Gymshark model? Confidence won't unclog your arteries. 1,350 likes. Or the ever so eloquent, this ain't it.
I've been going to the gym now for 4 years, almost every day. The longest I took off was a week when I went on vacation in Florida. Never in my life have I seen anybody at any of the gyms I've been at who looks like any of the people in fitness apparel company ads. Like, I've seen leaner people at the gym, but they're never as muscular, or I've seen more muscular people at the gym, but they're never as lean. I've never seen anybody in my life who looks the way people do in any of these athletic wear companies' ads. How many of the people that buy Gymshark's clothes or any other athletic apparel company's clothes are buying the size extra small or small? How many of those people have a six pack? How many of those people are a fitness model? How many of those people compete in bodybuilding? Gymshark made 176 million euros of sales last year. And I don't think those 176 million euros came from people who are 5% body fat, because there just isn't enough of them in the world. They came from normal people who are probably buying sizes medium to large. The fact that there's finally somebody on a Gymshark ad who looks like the people who are buying their products, I don't think should be that controversial of a topic.
It's just a marketing strategy. You're surfing on something to reach more clients and, of course, more money.
You know what's a marketing strategy? Artificially taking in people's waists, or artificially increasing people's butts, adding a thigh gap, or removing cellulite. Putting people that actually wear your clothes in your ads is not a marketing strategy. That's the reality of what most people who wear Gymshark probably look like wearing Gymshark.
Insanity! So you're a fitness page that posts about unfit people and tells your fan base who's trying to look like your athletes, nah, just stay eating donuts all day, but if you wear our clothes, we'll say it's alright. You're getting fit people to buy your clothes, and now you've tripled your business because you're getting unfit people who have no business wearing your clothes, and they are buying them too. You guys are geniuses.
The fitness industry is not exclusively for people who compete in bodybuilding, and it's not exclusively for people who are fitness models. If anything, the job of the fitness industry is to talk to people who are afraid to go to the gym, or who don't know what to do, or who want to make a change but aren't sure where to start. That's what the fitness industry is for. That's who it should be marketed to. You don't need people who compete in bodybuilding to be told to exercise. They already know to exercise and they love it. I don't understand why somebody who doesn't look shredded has no business wearing athletic clothes. If anything, people who aren't the leanest of lean are the people who are buying athletic clothes more than the lean people. Like, those are people who we need to be buying athletic clothes. Those are the people who are wearing Gymshark. Those are the people who should be shown what Gymshark will look like on them. And by the way, no one in this post is saying eat donuts all day.
Because we are all both soft whilst also being incredibly strong. Beautiful words, beautiful body, beautiful soul.
Nothing about her body says eat donuts all day. Nothing about her account says eat donuts all day. There's just a picture of someone who isn't super lean which this person has translated to equals unhealthy / eating donuts all day. And that's the main thing I want to talk about next, is this equation of health to thinness, which I fell into for most of my life. The question I have for all these people is, how are you defining health and fitness? Is it BMI? Because if it is, then a lot of athletes are obese and extremely unhealthy. Is it body fat percentage? Because in that case, anorexic people must be super, super healthy. Is it what you can do in the gym? Because we have no idea what this girl can do in the gym. There's no video, it's just a picture of her. Is it what you're eating? Is it your blood markers? Was there a medical report included in this? Like, where is the information in this post that tells us this girl is at all unhealthy?
Gymshark just doing this for the social media, lmao. That girl has no business representing fitness. I'm all for body positivity, but this is supposed to be a fitness brand. That lady is not fit whatsoever. She doesn't represent the brand properly. From this post, I'm now assuming Gymshark is a brand for overweight people.
Most of the people wearing Gymshark look a lot more like this lady than they do like the Gymshark athletes. I think this comment and a lot of the comments make a lot more sense if you replace the word healthy or fit with skinny.
I'm all for body positivity, but this is supposed to be a fitness brand. That lady is not skinny whatsoever. She doesn't represent the brand properly. From this post, I am now assuming Gymshark is a brand for overweight people.
The only metric that people are using to describe this girl as unhealthy is the fact that she's not super shredded. And I can tell you right now from personal experience, when I was 30 pounds lighter and probably what these people would consider more healthy, I wasn't getting my period, my thyroid had stopped working, I was exercising twice a day, I was eating 1,000 calories and half of it was protein powder, I couldn't sleep, and my hair was falling out. That was not healthy just because I was skinnier.
That's not beautiful, that's unhealthy. Sure, be happy in your own skin, but don't tell us that's beautiful, and sure as hell don't promote that as healthy for a gym page. Don't normalize having a diabetic body, please. Ah well, here we go again, normalizing diabetic bodies.
I wasn't aware that any of the people in these comments were this girl's doctors. I don't think it's fair to impose a medical diagnosis on someone you don't know. By the way, for the record, there's a lot of people who are technically overweight who don't have diabetes, and there are people who are normal weight who do have diabetes. But most importantly, if you're so concerned about health, then you should apply your concerns to people on both extremes, people who are very, very overweight and people who are also very, very underweight. Bodybuilding is by no means the picture of health. In a lot of these fitness companies, the male athletes take steroids, the female athletes aren't getting their periods and undereat, and I'm sure there are athletes that are very healthy, but bodybuilding in particular, if you are actually competing, is not a healthy thing. I don't see any comments about concerns over people's health on posts where somebody is super shredded.
Promoting unhealthy lifestyles to conform, aka they mean conform, with political correctness and thus increase revenue and likes by keeping the delusion population delusional. I don't know what the delusion population is.
What in this post is promoting an unhealthy lifestyle? I don't think there's anybody who sees this post and goes, oh yeah, I'm gonna go have McDonald's now. Or, oh yeah, I'm never gonna exercise. If anything, people who might have been afraid to go to the gym or work out might see this post and say, oh, maybe I can go to the gym. Maybe if I get these cute clothes and I feel nice in them, I'll have the courage to work out in front of other people. Maybe there's other people like me who are doing their best to live healthy and don't have to be so lean. That is what the post is promoting. If anything, people read these comments and decide to be unhealthy. It's exactly because of comments like this that people don't want to go to the gym, because they think everybody at the gym is an asshole like this. If anybody took the time to read even a single study on the topic of weight stigma, you would see in about 0.2 milliseconds that weight stigma only makes things worse. Treating people as being fat or unfit only makes them eat more, only makes them exercise less, and that's not even the worst that these comments promote, because the other thing that could happen from comments like this is promoting eating disorders, which, by the way, if you took 2 seconds to click on this girl's profile, you'll see that her bio says,
Nelly London, fashion, normal stuff, lingerie, eating disorder recovery.
I just think it's really sad that people are body shaming someone who is in eating disorder recovery, who has clearly struggled with their body, according to her bio, and who is now hopefully eating normally and is now being publicly shamed on a post that was supposed to be celebrating fitness for all people. People who are on the verge for developing eating disorders read all these comments on this post, and that is the kind of stuff that pushes you to do drastic things. That is the kind of stuff that pushed me to do water fasts for 3 days at a time for every month of 2018. Something else that's important to note is an observation that a few people made in the comments.
It's funny how most of the troll comments come from men. Like, TF, you don't know what's healthy to a woman's body and what's not. Noticing that 99% of the comments about this woman's perfectly normal body are coming from men.
I'm just really tired of men always deciding what is and isn't appropriate for a woman's body. I don't understand what gives any person a right to say anything about anybody's body. I don't really want to make this a gendered issue because it's not, in the sense that body shaming is body shaming no matter what. And a lot of people pointed out in the comments that Gymshark is posting body positive posts about women but not about men. And I think this is something that they're working on because that's what they said in their replies. But the fact is that a lot of the negative comments were coming from men.
On this topic, here's a story from my sister that tangentially relates.
Wendy, can you close both doors when you come?
All the grown-ass.
Hi, grown-ass white men.
There's no grown-ass white men that subscribe to this channel.
I think they are your only subscribers for two reasons.
One, two.
So recently I posted on my story this post that really resonated with me. She posted a picture like in the mirror with like her cellulite and acne scars, and like had the hashtag normalize normal bodies, which really resonated with me because two of the things that I worry about most because of like the image that traditional media portrays and like pushes are my cellulite and my acne scars. So I really appreciated the post. I posted it on my story and I got like quite a few responses from people signing up. And for the most part, it was just other girls being like, oh, this really made me feel like a lot better. Or like, I'm gonna go follow this girl now because this really resonated with me, whatever. There was, however, only one negative response, and that was from a boy. And he was like, I just don't like find it like good that this post is pushing that it's okay for people to be overweight or blah blah blah, and like somehow mentioned diabetes in the mix. What then followed was me explaining like, oh, this is why this post resonated with me, because I've never seen pictures of girls on Instagram like with cellulite, and like that's always something that people edit out of their photos, so I really like that this girl didn't edit it out, blah blah blah. And he's like, well, what actually resonates with people is blah. And I'm like, that's really funny because this post was made for girls who are suffering from the traditional image that media portrays. And it wasn't meant for like little prepubescent teen boy you who like has never had to worry about these issues. I'm not saying that men don't suffer from like images that are portrayed by media, but I think it's a lot more from the girl's perspective. Like, a lot more things are edited out and blah, blah, blah. You can understand that pretty clearly from the Gymshark photo. It's like, what am I trying to say? I forget.
I just don't understand why all of a sudden men become experts on health. When
I hate how bad I am explaining things. But that's what I'm saying.
I've never seen people care about health, because I guarantee you these people will like drink a soda or like have candy and not mention health or diabetes. But you see somebody who's not the typical Gymshark shredded and all of a sudden it's about health and diabetes.
Yeah, that's what I mean. It's just really weird to me that like this post like didn't at you in any single way. Like it wasn't trying to talk to you in any single way. It was trying to talk to teen girls that are feeling victimized by media, right? And like, why did this boy like, and like also that he's like, oh no, this is problematic because of the way that it's gonna resonate wrong with people, when the only person that it resonated wrong with was him. Yeah, a lot of people try to like boil down everything health-wise to your weight. Like, if you're overweight, you're unhealthy, and that's indicative of the way you eat and your fitness regime and like whatever. when, like, there are so many other factors at play, and, like I said, like, genetics, whatever, the way your body's built, like, that stuff doesn't really change with weight for the most part. It's weird to me. It's like, you're not the person suffering from these issues. Why are you commenting on the way that, like, people are trying to address them? Like, you're just not part, like, you're not part of that conversation. Stop trying to butt in, jackass.
Also, this is the reason, like, when I post YouTube videos, this is the reason I get nervous to post YouTube videos. This is the reason I get nervous to post Instagram videos. This is why I feel like I can't post this stuff. I don't deserve to post this stuff because, like, I'm not what they're looking for when, like, they're looking for fitness people. And it's like, this is the whole reason people don't like fitness people. They think everybody's like this, which they're not. I'm going to close out the video now.
Okay. Oh, man. I hate that I'm bad at explaining. Hey. Just because I'm bad at explaining myself doesn't mean that I don't have points
being made. I don't think you're bad at explaining. I think you explained it good.
But also, if you think that I explained it good, then I'm confident in my answer.
So the point of all of this was to say, I think most people look much closer to this girl than they do to a lot of other people who are, quote, the fitness industry. I think that if there were more posts like this, that more people would get into fitness and that we would all be better off and everybody would be healthier. Oh, and by the way, if you want to see some savage replies, you should just go through and read Gymshark's replies to all of them because they're pretty funny. Thanks so much for watching. Like, subscribe if you haven't already. And sorry for two serious videos in a row, but next one won't be so serious, hopefully. So see you guys in the next video.